जनाब असदुद्दीन ओवासी जी।
At the outset, let me say very clearly that I feel let down by the president's address because this is going to be the ninth presidential debate and the reply would begin by the Honorable Prime Minister. Muslims have a right to feel aggrieved and feel let down. The reason being that, sir, recently employment and unemployment survey of India 2009 and 10 done by NSSO has come out, which clearly says that the literacy level of Muslims for both Muslim OBC and general Muslims is as low or as compared to ST, SCA and Hindu OBC and Hindu general. Literacy levels of STs and SCs have improved both in rural and urban, but not for Muslims. When it comes to matriculation, sir, in both rural and urban areas, Muslims have the lowest matriculation levels, in fact, lower than SCs and STs. And if you compare the period from 2009 to 2010, the levels have gone down. There has been no improvement in matriculation level. Thirdly, when it comes to higher levels of education, there has been in urban areas in Muslim general a 1.5 percentage point net decline over the 5 years period of data comparison, whereas it has improved for other STs, SCs, Hindu OBCs, Hindu general and other minorities. It has increased to 5 to 9 percentage point. The gap is increasing. Why this is happening? Because no substantive action has been taken by this government. When you come to employment, public employment, sir, 2010 and 11, there is no minority representation in Department of Scientific and Industrial Research, no minority representation in Department of Land Reforms, there is no minority representation in Ministry of Law and Justice, in Social Justice and Empowerment, in Department of Food and Public Distribution. In MOD, sir, in 2010-11, 800 recruitments were made, only 50 belonging to minorities were given. This speaks volumes about your 15-point program. In Department of Biotechnology, same thing. In Department of Financial Services, Group A and B, 10-11, sir, 4,702 recruited for minority community out of 65,000. This clearly shows. And then Planning Commission says, sir, that the poverty ratio estimates for Muslims in urban areas 33.9%. Where will we go if this is the representation in public employment? In rural areas, the headcount ratio for Muslims very high, sir. In states like Assam, it is 53%, UP 44%. West Bengal 34.4 and Gujarat 31.4.
This is headcount ratio.
Headcount ratio of rural areas given by Planning Commission. My point over here is that if these are the poverty ratios in rural areas, we are not getting our share in MNREGA. We are not getting our share in MNREGA. And what is the calculation? Only 3% of Muslims hold job card, and at 2 per 100 workers are Muslims. When the poverty ratios, headcount ratio is very high in states like Assam, UP, West Bengal and Gujarat, what is the government doing in monitoring 15-point program? When you come to issue of SGSY, targets are not being met. Anganwadi center, sir, target was 27,598, only 12,363 have been realized. You come to sanction of teachers in district with substantial minority population. In 2011 and 12, out of 32,728, only target was 32,000. What was the achievement? 7,603. KGBs in district with substantial minority population, 11 and 12, 109 were announced, only 32 have been achieved. And now what is the percentage of Muslim girls in this KGBV? Throughout nation, it's only 9%. This again speaks volume of 15-point program. In UP, for example, 200 KGBVs are there, only 14% of minority girls are there.
What is KGBV?
School buildings, sir, target was 705, general. Only 228 have been achieved. Additional classrooms, 13,883, only 5,200 have been achieved. That is why we are saying, we have recommended to the Prime Minister, pleaded with the Prime Minister, but unfortunately nothing moves over here. We have said you make these schemes post-matric, pre-matric and merit come means demand-driven. There is no constitutional bar on that. But what the government does, it does not agree to it. 12th five-year plan has started. The ministry has asked for 28,000 crore only for the scholarship scheme. What the Planning Commission decides that no, for the Ministry of Minority, only 17,000 crore will be given. Where will we go? Why don't you want, there is a huge demand, there is a huge demand for scholarship scheme. For one Muslim scholarship scheme, 250 boys and girls are competing. So there is a huge interest in Muslims to get their children educated. But when you go at the top level, at the 12th standard, at the graduation level, the figures are pathetic. Why? Because you're not coming forward to support us. Why is this government, I want to ask them, what happened to the commitment of prevention of communal target violence? Where is that bill? If If the other parties are not agreeing, why can't you tell your Congress ruled states to bring a law which will control communal violence? You take Maharashtra, Dhulia firing happened. What happened? It took 12 days for the government to realize. Rajasthan, Bharatpur, 10 Muslims are butchered inside a masjid. Assam. These are incidents. These are Assam, it has happened. Now you come to figures given by the Home Ministry, sir. 2005 and 9, 648 people have been killed in communal violence. This number is higher than the fatalities which have happened in terrorist violence. It is high time that the government brings this bill. This bill was passed by NAC. And now come to the last point, sir. Ejaz Ahmed Mirza, a DRDO scientist, was released today. He was released today by why? Because NIA did not find any evidence against him. His contract was terminated by DRDO for what reason? He had a 2-year contract as a scientist. We, as a community, we don't have scientists in our community. He was wrongly implicated. He was released by NIA. The DRDO has cancelled his contract. And I want to know from this government, what sort of secularism are you practicing? You have Colonel Prohit, who's lodged in jail in Maharashtra for 4 years. And the same MOD is giving him his pay, his salary for last 4 years. Why don't you monitor all these things? And this was revealed not by me. This was revealed by an RT application filed by Major Upadhyaya, who's a co-accused with Colonel Prohit. The government does not know about it. And another issue which I want to bring to your notice, sir. There's a high time to disband. It is the right time to disband Delhi Special Police Cell, or at least create a responsible accountable mechanism. The Jamia Teachers Association have come out with 16 cases wherein all these boys exonerated. They spent 4 years, 5 years, 8 years. And now the government says, give us example. I am giving you 16 cases of those boys who were exonerated by courts of law, who were picked up by Delhi Special Police Cell. Does this government has the guts to suspend the Delhi police officers who have destroyed their lives? And lastly, sir, when it comes to Afzal Guru, I don't want to comment on a sentence. But my question to the government is, I'm concluding, sir. When it comes to Afzal Guru, you have one politician from Haryana who's convicted, who can speak on a telephone call and address a public meeting in Haryana. But you cannot, you didn't have the courtesy to at least allow his wife to speak to him before he was given hanged. What kind of humanism you are practicing over here? What kind of message you are sending over here? And I want to know, what is the fate of Ranganath Mishra Commission? The recommendations, where have they gone? You are in your 9th year, you have to go to the public. The Muslims are not going to accept these announcements. They want to see some practical change. Development in my life, which unfortunately it is not there, sir. It has not happened. Terrorism related cases, sir, terrorism is a new religion. It has no... Why should we divide when the terrorists are hurting us, killing us? They don't see whether I'm a Hindu or Muslim. But no, we want to politicize this. We want to cast aspersions on it. It is high time that the country gets united. And for God's sake, control this media. This media, after every bomb blast, after half an hour, they know what happened. If that is the case, then the media anchor should be made the Home Minister of this country. Let us have all these media anchors who sit on their throne at 9 o'clock and pronounce judgments. They know everything. Where is this information coming from? And lastly, sir, I request the government of India to examine my proposal of opening a diplomatic channel with Taliban. In 2014, US is leaving Afghanistan. We have invested crores of rupees in development of Afghanistan. If we don't engage with them, then we'll be allowing our neighboring country to enter over there, use that territory for anti-national activities. When Gulf countries have opened an embassy, Western countries are talking to them. I once again urge upon the government, please act on your promises. Your promises are going to make difference whether you come back here or not. If not, the Muslims have another fourth route also. It is not third, but a fourth route also. Please ensure that these promises are implemented. Thank you, sir.